May I please request Madam Mohini Daljeet Singh, ma'am, to deliver the special address. Please, over to you, ma'am. Please. May I please request our team to bring the bouquet to honor her? Yeah. Please, ma'am.
After my last fall, I don't want to take any more chances. Namaste and good morning to everyone. I'd first like to wish everybody a very, very happy Women's Day. Now, unlike one of our friends who said he would like to wish the women, I think it's very important to wish everyone. Because honestly, Women's Day cannot be happy without the cooperation and the efforts of the men. And this is something which all of us today, being Women's Day, talking about girls, talking about education, I want to say this, that from the beginning, so everyone has a different beginning, so let's see, say for us, how important it is for the family, for the man and the woman to begin on a platform of mutual equal respect. Hum ardhangini kehte hain, but hum equal partnership kahan hai? And you know, it's something, I'm sure all of you have been bothered about it for the last few years, ki ye itne rape cases, itne aggressive and violent behavior against women, ye kaise kis mein aa sakti hai? Ye hum logon ko to taju bhi lagta hai, how has it happened? And I would just say this is what those boys or those people have picked up from their environment. It's obviously you're a product of your environment, isn't it? So you have picked it up from the environment. Did you hear your father mistreating your mother so badly that your respect for women is that? Could be. Wo kahin to seekha hai na, kahin to wo beej utpan hua hai. So jab tak hum log sab, especially the men, I would say, begin on this path of equal respect, there can be no happy Women's Day. We are into 2018, and we say India shining, we say we are the economy of the future. I think we are just regressing. Itna to humne kabhi bhi nahi dekha tha, jo abhi ye bura haal ho raha hai. It's really, really going down. So where is the solution? I would say the easiest, the first thing is education. Right, so education of whom, of everybody, the boy and the girl, the man and the woman at every level. So education, but education is not simply literacy. आप केवल स्कूल चले जाओ तो आप एजुकेटेड नहीं हो सकते जैसे कि कुछ डिस्कशंस अभी हुई हैं वी आर डिबेटिंग व्हाट स्कूल्स आर गुड व्हाट आर बैड एंड what is the meaning of education? So perhaps if we came to education in the real sense, maybe there would be a change of attitude, a change of behavior. This is really needed, a behavioral change across the board, no matter if you are an auto driver or rickshaw driver or you are in an office job or you are the director of a company, we are all affected by the same environment. So this education bit is very, very important here. Education in the right sense with values and with a real base, base in reality. And here I want to connect with the reality with science. What is science? I was just thinking, what am I speaking about tomorrow? You know, this whole week is Women's Day and we're speaking of different things. I just pulled out a definition of science. So I just want to point out a few very crucial words in this. Okay, it's an intellectual and practical activity. Practical means practice, jisko hum istemal kar sakte hain zindagi mein, practical activity. It's a systematic study. So it's organized, you know. There are phases, there are steps, how you have to learn, what you need to learn. Then it is a study of the structure and behavior. Two things. Structure is always physical, behavior is at a mental level. Of the physical world. We are all in a physical world. So we need to study the structure and the behavior of it. How? In a practical manner. How? With observation and experiment. So I would say that science is living life, practically, with meaning. Would all of you agree there? So therefore, let's come back and realize that there can be no real education without science. We know, those of us who know a little bit about our history and background, you know, we love to sort of show and throw about that, you know, Aryabhat, and we came out with the zero, and how besides Greece and Egypt, we were the leaders. What has happened to us today? No doubt we've had many scientists of Indian origin who, you know, got the Nobel Prize. Khurana is one name that comes to my mind. There are many others. But we are not talking of those exceptions today. We are talking about the 1.3 billion Indians on one side. And on the other side, every day we say, we don't have enough doctors, we don't have enough policemen, we don't have enough teachers, we don't have enough soldiers, we don't have enough of anything. Why? Why? So, yes, training, but training will come after education, proper education. Kuch baat hui thi about classrooms. Remember that even Shanti Niketan, you can study under a tree. What is the crux and the nucleus of a school? It is the teacher. All of us would agree. Now, I have been an army wife, and in my younger years, when I moved at an average of 1.5 years, the only thing I could really do to contribute to society, to my own mental peace and my own self-esteem, I taught. And believe me, when I got married straight after college at 20, I was not trained. But you know, I went to admit my child and the principal just got after me, apni application do. I said, maine to socha bhi nahi hai, main padhana hai ki nahi padhana. She said, do. So when I started teaching, I thought, wow, I'm doing a good job. And I could see instantly my gratification, because I could make out like I can now, ki meri baat kaun sun raha hai, kaun nahi sun raha. Aur usi din pata chal jata hai ki is bache ne sikha kya hai, kya nahi. It's the most gratifying job. So when my children were in class 3 and 4, and my husband was on a non-family station, I did my B.Ed. When my son went to college, I did my M.A. Because I said, if I can teach, I must teach senior classes. Anyway, this is not about me. But I had an experiment. You see, I am heading Max India Foundation now. We work on the healthcare platform, basically. But in 3 geographies where we have so-called adopted villages, we wanted to go beyond. Beyond giving injections to the school children and beyond seeing their health, we couldn't help because wo hamare hi the, you know, hamara hi parivar ban gaya tha. We went into the school aspect as well. And we started looking at, you know, how they are doing. The first thing, when I started the foundation, the first year, the first school I went to, which is a village next to our factory in Punjab, I was told ki ek maths teacher nahi, English teacher nahi hai. I almost had a heart attack. I said, bachche class 10 ka exam de rahe, maths teacher nahi hai. I mean, I could imagine myself, you know. So I said, immediately, I told my team, please hire a very good maths teacher, English teacher from the town nearby. This is, I'm talking about a government high school in the village. Okay, so we hired a teacher for both the subjects, and I said, I will pay after school for them, and please for a glass of milk and biscuits for the children, so they have to stay back. And this was started on 16th of January, because we launched on 15th of January, 2008. 16th ko ye classes shuru hue, 1st March ko board exam shuru hua. So I said, do board exam ke doran bhi karte raho, so that till the maths class and the English class. So that much only they got extra. You know, the results, Nick, when they came, I felt it was my result coming out, you know. But when the result came, 58% children passed, compared to 22 in the previous year. So I said, look, let's please continue this from July. Next year, humne ye continue kara. Do you know, for the first time in the history of the school, 100% children passed. So, bachcho mein koi dosh nahi hai. Koi dosh nahi hai bachcho mein. Jis tarah se hum unhe padha rahe hain, hum kya padha rahe hain? Now, many times I went to the school and I would see a lot of people in the staff room, feet up and all. You know, in January, before the board exam, I visited the school myself and had a talk with the children, motivated them. I said, if any of you get more than 75%, I'll pay for your education. I knew that Max India Foundation will not pay for any education. But I still said it. I said, dekhi jayegi, ab main khud de dungi. But you know, 69 was highest, but all passed. And nobody could believe it, ki aaj tak to kabhi hua nahi. Because na to wo expectation rakhte hain, na bachon ki respect karte hain, na maa baap ko kuch hai, wo to kheti karte hain, you know. So there's nothing wrong with our children. Really, they are gems. You have to just make them interested in coming to school. Jaise kisi ne kaha hai ki khushi se is bachcha school jaye, usse aur badhiya kya ho sakta hai. And learning by doing, those of us who have taught or I know anything about education. You see, we all have the five senses. Ye to aapko sab pata hi hai. You know, hearing, seeing, touching, whatever they are. Now, the more senses we involve, the better it is, isn't it? Kyunki aapne ek bar dekha ya ek bar kitab padhi, aapko pata nahi yaad rahega. But agar aapko humne aap dobara aap khud bhi kahenge, phir agar aap dekhenge video par ya kisi cheez par. So for that, in Max India Foundation, when we do health camps, we have got puppet shows. Puppeters, through their program, show same thing. Haath dhona, dengue ka bachav kaise karna, wo ek natak banke. Aur wo cheez bachche nahi bolte hain. Agar hum bar bar bolenge, dekho tum haath dho, sabun se haath dhona, I don't think they'll remember. So learning by doing and experiencing, you can imagine how amazing it is for children. I don't know, some of you may remember your own days in the lab. Agar choti si cheez and you say ke aise hoga, and they say, wow, iska to rang badal gaya. You know, small thing like sulfur, whatever it used to be. I've forgotten the thing that turns blue and green. But you know, small things like that for children are unforgettable moments. Absolutely. So therefore, if we are looking at, now let me come to another level and then I'll come back to this. We are looking at development, at progress, at an India. Then we come back to say, how will we do it? The first thing is education, education, education. Science with value based. That's all. Science means everything. Because it's a scientific bent of mind. It's maths, it's arts, there's geography, maybe science, history, maybe science, all of it. So from there, we can get to a point where people are not only learning by rote, not only doing exams, ya joote mein parchiya laga ke pass, wo samajh rahe hain. To aap koi bhi prashn karo, not direct questions. Abroad, it doesn't happen. I've got grandchildren in Singapore. Every day, I'm amazed at the work they do and the kind of questions that little fellow in class six is doing. It's all project work. It's all thinking and analysis. That will bring us this analytic bent of mind, which starts with the scientific bent. Analyze karne ki shakti ki himmat. Then, but you can only do that if you've understood the concepts and principles. Once you have done that, you can analyze and you can get anywhere. That is when there'll be a breakthrough. We will be able to respect each other's points of view. We will be able to respect if somebody comes to me with a project that this is how I worked it. You know, when we talk about Startup India, Make in India, that is the, going to be the breakout point. When we have villagers from Chhattisgarh, Bihar, anywhere. And believe me, like somebody said, the government schools are not all bad. We have done some water filtration plants in some schools. You know, South Delhi Municipal Corporation. The day I went to inaugurate it, they had a science exhibition. I was totally floored. I spent 3 hours looking at the models. Mujhe yakeen nahi aa raha tha ki ye bachon ne itna badhiya kaam kiya hai. And the teachers. So it's not that. It's just that, you know, sincerity of intent on part of teachers, on part of the government, they have to give the teachers the respect. Even us as parents, we say, arre usko kya pata, us to 20-25,000 kamati. That kind of talk we do in front of our children. What respect will they have of the teacher also? So we can do this and we can bring it up. And I have to tell you, although I'm not marketing Ashutosh, but I have to say something, that I had gone for a seminar in Bombay where the STEM learning people had put up a, you know, they'd put up their exhibition, their stall outside. Believe me, 3 times from the hall I went out, I was more fascinated. Ye wala bana ke dikhao, ye wala karo. They had set up the entire thing. And there and then, even though, as I've told you, we don't do education. And I was wondering, but we have 3 villages where we have adopted them, and we do a lot of work in the school. I've given audiovisual, you know, equipment also. I said even then we do health-related topics. Then we've given them drinking water. Then we've given them games equipment. Ultimately, I said, no, they have to have it. They have to have it. And I'm really happy to say all 3 have been installed. The third one, which is in Punjab, I'm going to inaugurate in the next few days, but it's there. I know, as he mentioned, that again the crux is the teacher. Kyunki wo kai baar wo sham out, you know, like I went to the school, the one in Dhakrani near Dehradun. It was very new building, luckily they had from the government. And I told the principal, principal sahab, agar ye aise hi pade rahe na, like shining models, to fir to koi fayda nahi hai. You know, they have to be used. So we can only do as much as we can. Now my request is to all those in the CSR space, we are doing amazing work. At least I hope. I'm doing amazing work. I don't know about others. A lot of people think it's all jaise ki aina saaf kahin aur kar rahe hain, gand kahin aur hai, ho sakta hai. But so much money, I think we have started really making a difference. Please do it sincerely, which you can do. And these are things, kyunki, you know, mostly kya hota hai, main corporates ki baat kar rahi hoon, abhi NGOs ki nahin. Aap log NGOs zyada on ground hote hain, but main corporate ki taraf se hote hue bhi, hum log na corporate hain, na NGO, because Max India Foundation does everything on the ground with their own hands there. I mean, I monitor, I go to the villages every month. Of course, my team goes more. We do camps. I try to be around whenever. We've done lots of stuff. So even if you are from a corporate, to aap dekhiye, aap jaiye, aap monitor kijiye, aapka paisa hai na? Doesn't it worry you? It worries me, every rupee of mine. I insist, I get reports every quarter from every NGO that we, they even send us original bills. जब हम न्यूट्रिशन सपोर्ट करते हैं मैं वो फ्रूट की बिल्स भी मंगवाती हूँ दे माइट बी थिंकिंग शी इज़ अ बिट टू बट आई डोंट डजंट मैटर आई वांट टू नो व्हाट डिड द चिल्ड्रन ईट राइट सो आई वुड जस्ट सजेस्ट टू यू दैट यू नो यू आर ग्रेट चेंज मेकर्स फील द पावर दैट यू वील्ड इफ वन चाइल्ड इज चेंज्ड माई गॉड यू हैव डन समथिंग यू हैव मोल्डेड दैट चाइल्ड रियली So you have a great power, please use it. Thoda sa aapko monitor hi karna hai na. Aap to sincere ho, aap dekhiye ki jo on ground last tak ja raha hai, wo itna sincere hai ki nahi. Kabhi kabhi dekh lijiye, jaiye, kabhi suggestions kariye, change, suggestions lijiye. We learn a lot even from the villagers. So I think it'll be wonderful. So I would like to once again Firstly, rather, I would like to thank the organizers. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. So my talk was on 2 levels, starting with Women's Day. Let's not make it only Women's Day. Let's make it an equal partnership day every day. every day. You know, that is when we will start changing as a country. Aur sirf main nahi, hamari apni a maid hai, apna driver hai. मतलब हर लेवल तक ये ले जाएं, कभी-कभी बात कीजिए, उनको ये भी समझाएं कि जो लड़की होना, लड़का होना, you know, is not the woman's fault. You know, a lot of things you've got to take on your hands. Don't ever be shy. My mantra has been, and I want to share it, if you have the opportunity to make a difference, just do it. Thank you.
May I please request our volunteers to bring the memento for Madam Mohini Daljeet Singh. May I please request Ashutosh Panditji to deliver the memento to ma'am.
Thank you.
In the meantime, I'll just give a brief about madam. She's been the CEO of Max India Foundation and has been doing a pioneering work in the domain of CSR. And she has won several awards, including Golden Peacock Award for CSR for 4 consecutive years. And she also received Asia's Greatest CSR Brand Leadership Award. Thank you very much, ma'am, for being with us. Thank you so much. Big round of applause, please.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm very humbled by the invitation and by your words. Thank you so much.